So I think that one of the depressors, one of the big depressors of voting is big money in campaigns. It just turns people so totally off. All this money coming in saying, without any, where does this money come from? And what coming in with misrepresentations, whether it's about the Affordable Care Act, whether it's about immigration, whatever it is, that issues that are important to people's lives are being so mischaracterized. Pox on both your houses, I'm not even going to vote. I don't know if you saw, they had a report that why people didn't vote. Something in the 60s said, I didn't have time. And then another chunk, I was busy with work or school. And another time was something that related to time as well. Well, all of that adds up to, it wasn't important enough for me. Now, for some, it is a legitimate time concern. If you're working two jobs, having to go from here to there, you can't stand in line for long hours when people have deterred the vote for you in your community by reducing the hours, reducing the days, reducing the polling places, reducing the machines. So there are a lot of things that contribute to that. But the overarching thing, I think, is that not enough people saw that it was really important to their well-being that they vote. The Republicans called it as a base election. They got out their base, impeached the president, sued the president, all that negative stuff. And again, that was a depressant. The strangulation of the airwaves by big money is so undemocratic, and that's why I fault the Supreme Court for the Citizens United decision.